Assalamu alaikum dear student, how are you? I hope you are all well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIEVS Homeschool. I am Nasima Akhtar, Assistant Teacher of Science, National Ideal English Version School, Morningship. Today I am going to take a science class for class 7 student. So dear student, today's topic is Chapter 2, Creative Question and Answer. That means I will discuss about creative question and answer based on this chapter. At first we will read the question properly. Here is a picture, this is your stem, and A number question is, what is diurnal motion? B number question is, why does it rain heavily in Bangladesh in between June and July? C number question is, when do the smallest nights and longest days occur at southern hemisphere? Explain with the figure. D number question is, what will the length of the day and night on 30 December at the northern hemisphere? Answer the question showing logical grounds. Let's start the answer. First question was, what is diurnal motion? Answer is, the earth's rotation on its own axis from west to the east once in 24 hours is called diurnal motion. Next question was, why does it rain heavily in Bangladesh in between June and July? Answer is, B number answer is, it rains heavily in Bangladesh from mid-June to mid-July, as on the date 21 June, Bangladesh comes closer to the sun. The days becomes longer and night shorter, and the sun shines vertically. As a result, around this time, in spite of much temperature, heavy rainfall occurs as an effect of monsoon wind. C number question was, when do the smallest nights and longest day occur at southern hemisphere? Explain with the figure. Okay, dear student, in this question answer you have to draw this figure. So answer is, according to the picture, it can be said that the shortest night and the longest day in the southern hemisphere is 22 December. It is seen in the picture that a part of southern hemisphere faces the sun on 22 December. You can see the picture, southern hemisphere, it faces the sun 22 December. The sun becomes inclined to the south at that time and it gives light vertically on the southern hemisphere. Summer prevails in the southern hemisphere then, so it is the shortest night and longest day in the southern hemisphere. For instance, Australia, the country situated in the southern hemisphere, has the longest day and shortest night on 22 December. D number question was, what will the length of the day and night on 30 December at the northern hemisphere? Answer the question showing logical ground. Answer is, the length of the day would be shorter and the length of the night would be longer in the northern hemisphere on 30 December, because because a part of southern hemisphere faces the sun indirect inclinedly on 21 December, as the sun shines vertically over the southern hemisphere, the day are longer and night are shorter there. On the other hand, as the sun stays farther from the northern hemisphere, it shines obliquely and for less time there, around the date 21 December. The days are shorter and the night are longer in the northern hemisphere. That means opposite situation of southern hemisphere. Now I will start two number creative question. Here is a stamp, here is the picture, solar system. First question is a number question. How long does it take for the moon to move round the earth? B number question is, why is Pluto not the member of the solar system? C number, which one of the planet between number 3 and 4 remains dark? Explain. D number question is, why is the planet number 4 not suitable for human habitation in spite of having much similarities with planet number 3? Explain with argument. So we will start the answer. Answer A, question was, how long does it take for the moon to move round the earth? Answer is, it takes 27 days 8 hours for moon to revolve round the earth. B number question was, why is Pluto not the member of the solar system? Answer is, the luminary named Pluto was considered to be a planet of solar system, but since it is small and incomplete, the scientist removed Pluto as a member of the solar system in 2009. Now C number question was, which one of the planet between number 3 and 4 remains darker? Explain. Answer is, the third planet presented in the picture is the Earth and the fourth is Mars. According to the picture, the Earth is closer to the Sun than the Mars. The planet that is positioned further away from the Sun than the Earth is remain darker than the Earth. Planet those are nearer to Sun takes less time to rotate it. On the other hand, planet having much distance take more time to rotate Sun because it has to cover more areas. So planet number 4 Mars takes more time period of rotation and planet number 4 remains dark. Number D question was, why is the planet number 4 not suitable for human habitation in spite of having much similarities with planet number 3? Explain with arguments. Answer is, the third planet in the picture is the Earth and the fourth one is the Mars. The Earth is the only planet in which there is necessary elements and environment for living. The characteristics of the planet Mars is almost similar to that of, there can be water under the ground of the Mars. But the surface of the planet Mars is dusty and reddish and its atmospheric layer is very thin, for which planet Mars is not suitable for habitation of living organism. Dear student, this time you have to do some SW. Based on this creative question, your SW will be creative question. Number one, A, B and C. It will be your SW and you have to submit your SW in every Sunday from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. in our library, and you can collect your previous SW from same date, that means Sunday. So dear student, I hope you have understood today's topic. Keep practice at home, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.